In this video, I'm going to show you how to design a stacked bar chart in WeWeb. So here's the bar chart, the stacked bar chart we are going to design. It is showing us the number of car sales for Teslas and Fords. We can view only Teslas or none at all, or only Fords, or both of them stacked. So here, two Teslas were sold, two Fords, one Tesla. You get the idea. So to design this, a prerequisite is in your plugins, you need to have the charts extension. Okay, so once you've added this plugin, you will have access to specific chart elements. And you can simply drag and drop a bar chart on the page. So let's do this here. I will add it here. We recommend that you include the variable if you're just getting started to understand how it works. So then you have here in guided mode, you can see your fake data and you can see how it works. So here you see you have several items, and on the x-axis we're binding the month, so January, February, March, and on the y-axis we're displaying the data, and here, and we are doing a field summary, so summing the values of these items. Here we're going to unbind this because we already have our set of data. We have a collection with our bookings, and here you see it's an array of objects. So if I look at it here, I have 14 items, and if I go inside, I have an ID, car make, car model, date, user ID. So I have this information here. On my chart, I can bind this data, this array of items right here. And once I've done this, I have to tell the charts element what field I want to use for the X axis, so the horizontal axis, and what field I want to use, I want to display on the Y axis. So on my X axis, here you see I have the dates. So let me add the date. Here is my X axis, and here on the, for the Y, I'll just put the ID. So now I have information that looks like this. It doesn't seem quite right. So how do I group by the information based on the car make? I can use the group by field here to say by car make. And now suddenly I have two bars per day. That's good, but it's not quite the design I want. So let me see in the design tab. Let me enable stacked bars instead. So now it looks a little bit more like it, except that for some reason it's telling me 15 here and here 13. So what's happening here? Let's go back here, and what I see is that it's aggregating values, and since I chose the IDs, and the IDs are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it looks like it's doing a sum of this. So instead of value, I can choose distinct, and then I will see that it's actually two Fords and one Teslas, or three Fords and one Tesla. Another way of doing it would be to say item count. So I'm grouping by car make, and I'm just counting the number of items. That would be the same as doing a field summary where I'm counting the distinct IDs because my IDs are unique. So let's go the simple route and choose item count. Now I see a few things that are different from here. The first is that this doesn't seem to be ordered properly. So let me fix this. I'm going to order by X ascending and make sure that I include empty values. Now it's in the correct order, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Now, something that's different is my legend here is at the bottom and here it's at the top. So let me modify this. Here, I will change the position to bottom. Something else that seems to be different is the size. So let's see if I can make this bigger. Yes. And also it looks like I have a different height. So let me change the fixed width to 300. All right. And finally, it looks like here I have a background color and some corner radiuses. So let's do that here. I will change the background color to black. I will add some padding, let's say 16, and corner radius, say 8. There we go. And finally, the text seems to be a different color as well. So let's try this. There we go. And just if we wanted to, we could change the colors here. So we could say that instead of Ford being blue, we could say it's green. There we go. Oh boy, it hurts the eyes. So that's it. In a few minutes, I was able to recreate this chart. The most important thing to keep in mind is that in guided mode, the data you need to pass through is an array of objects with all the information in each object that you will need to do your binding so that the chart understands what you want to display. Now, if we wanted to do the same thing in advanced mode, it would be possible. We have the example here, but the data, it would be a very different approach. So this is guided mode, and this is the advanced mode. And here we would need to figure out our labels. So instead of having the dates in an object inside each item, you would have a labels array. And then you would have your data sets, two separate data sets, one for Tesla, one for Ford. So with your background color in the data, you would have to do the count to count the items on your own. So here, instead of the chart being able to count the number of items that have the Tesla as a car make, you would need to have a separate data set and pass it through here. And then all your style options, we need to be here. So the legend, information here, you're saying you want to display the legend and you want to display it at the bottom, and then you're saying that the labels of the legend would be in this color, and you're using the point style, because if we change the options to false here, for example, let's save this. Actually, let's copy this object and paste it here directly so we can make the changes here. Let me move here and paste the object. Now you see that it's square. So we can change this here. We can change the color here. So we could say it's red and oops, not with this. So now the text of the legend is red, but not the other text. So you see it's a little bit more complex. You have much more customization options, and all the customization options are available in the charts.js documentation. So if you want to use the advanced mode, we highly encourage you that you go through the charts.js documentation. You can try your own configuration in charts.js before moving to WeWeb. For example, if I type in stacked bar chart, here I could say, you know what, I'm not going to use these things. I'm going to use my labels instead. So you could say here, I'm simply going to say, tell chart.js what I want to display, and my data sets, I'm going to also add them to chart.js. So here my my data sets here. Let's see. Okay, so now you see I have something similar, and if I wanted to change my configuration, and I've already done the work before, so this is why it's easy for me right now, just because here my options, I could just say, copy them here and say, okay, there you go. So I probably did something wrong here with my options. Have one extra one. Yeah, there we go. So now I don't have my black background. So this is where the issue is coming from. So if I change to red, and then I could have a red grid, and then I would want my red grid for the x-axis as well. And I would want the text of my x-axis to be red as well here. And then I would want the legend to be red as well. So here, you see suddenly I'm making a lot more changes, and as you can see, like building this object, this first object and this second object and this third array. So here we have an array for data sets. We have an array of objects. Here we have an array, and for the configuration, we have an object with other nested objects. You can see it's much more complex, but it's also more powerful. You can go much further. So depending on your needs, you need to decide if the advanced mode is worth the trouble, or if you'd rather do the guided mode instead. And the big difference, again, is how you structure your data. Here in advanced mode, you need two data sets, and you have already done the sum of transactions, whereas in guided mode, you have an array of objects with all the information you need in each item. So depending on how the data is presented in your backend, you might need to do some work in your backend to return the data in the proper way, or to use a workflow on page load, for example, in WeWeb, to transform the data so that it's in a format that the guided or the advanced mode understands, depending on what you're trying to do. That's it. That's how you can design a stacked bar chart in WeWeb. The guided mode will allow you to build faster, but will have less customization options. The advanced mode has no limits. You have all the configuration options that are available in the Chart.js library. If you choose that option because you have strong customization needs, we recommend that you go through the Chart.js documentation to dig a little bit further, to test your chart design in the Chart.js documentation directly before moving to WeWeb and binding those labels, datasets, and options.